right, we're gonna take everything down that's got a yellow flag on it. That one is coming down. That cluster of hackberries is coming down. Those two right there, and then this little oak. So I've been working rather feverishly here recently, trying to get as much done as I can before the leaves get out on the trees. You can see that hackberry is starting to bud on out up there now. And just because they're a lot easier to mess with it, not near as much debris without the leaves in them. But that's fixing to come to an end. I'm going to be running my oldest 400 with a 25-inch bar. It's going to be an EXL chain on it, I think. That's what it is. Either an EXL Oregon or a 33RS steel. I'll look at it. I think it's an Oregon chain. So I worked here before. It's Mr. Roberts' place. Chris and I took down a big hackberry about a year ago, almost a year ago. Yeah, that's an Oregon. That's an EXL on that saw. Full chisel, full house. Shave these stumps. I'm not really going to grind them. We're just going to shave them down, kind of even with the ground. And this oak right here, I'm going to drop it right in the middle of this road. Kind of cheat it to the left. I cut that stump with my 572. I've got a semi-chisel chain on it. That stump's gonna be dirty there. And one of those old style Oregon bars, power mesh bars. Where I ain't jacking my good chains up. So that tree is leaning, it's curved over that away bad. But you see that rotten knot hole, and then look right up above it, you see that limb that's hung in behind. That one limb is holding that whole thing up and keeping it from falling. Don't cut your hinge. I ain't cut my hinge. I'm right there. You can see. So I still have control of this tree. If you cut that hinge, then you ain't got control of it. You cut that hinge, what that thing's going to do is it's going to drop, sit right down on the saw. Then it's sitting there. something, you see how narrow that hinge is on that thing. You notice how strong that hinge is. I can feel that doty part right there. This part right here. But that's irrelevant because all of this up here was good. So, and then I didn't cut out the back because I wanted to snap that on the back with the, you know, pushing on it and carry it. So right there beside my trailer, down this left side, like what I wanted to do, and everything. Watched a guy the other day, had a video pop up on my feed, and the guys, one of them homesteading channels, you know how they are, they all of them are jockeying for positions on that stuff, and some of them are legit, some of them are like what I'd say, they're trying to do something on YouTube, trying to make some money. This guy was gonna start trying to cut, he's gonna cut some trees down to clear a spot, and he ended up dropping a tree on a brand new Kubota side-by-side. And tore the front end of it up pretty bad. And there's a lot of people in the comments that, you know, was talking, you know, telling, hey, you know. It was not bashing him or anything, but he had no idea what he was doing. And that's the way these trees are. If you don't know and you don't know the ins and outs on them, get somebody else to do them for you. Last one's hackberry, and it was a big old fork tree. You see where it busted out right there, but this thing is a fork back, leaning back over the mini really, really bad. So what I'm about to do is I'm gonna carry it all the way over and back down this road here. Put a big old open face notch on it where that hinge will work as long as it can. It looks like the tree's still pretty sound. If this tree had any rot in it or anything, it's not gonna happen. So still looks pretty good. We'll see what we can do. I'll go ahead and cut this. I'm gonna cut this toward the ground. That way I can get all the levers that I need. I'm backwards on the mini where I got the blade behind me so I can dig it in the ground if I need to. I'm gonna send her that, give you an idea of how bad that thing's over the back right there. So yeah.
Oh. So if you notice, I cut that hinge probably to about 80% and left a little bit on the left where the tree would roll. See it rolling? Where it'd come on down and still attach the stump.
Show y'all what we were dealing with. See all the pollen come out of that thing? So when I cut my notch, I seen that this wasn't good right there. So I did go ahead and move my truck up a little bit further. That limb, I gotta pull that one down right there. It's hung. That big limb right there wrapped around this tree. And once I got it leaned over, then I just cut my hinge where the tree could roll and come on out of it and land right here. See ya? Got him down. I think that's the last one too.